हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस पैरेलल एंड सीरीज कनेक्शन ऑफ रेसिस्टेंस एंड चैप्टर इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑन दिस चैप्टर। आई होप यू हैव व्यूड फर्स्ट वीडियो ओम्स लॉ। सो वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज द पैरेलल एंड सीरीज कनेक्शन ऑफ रेसिस्टेंस। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल you see, if you have three resistance R1, R2, and R3, and one thing also I want to recall, I have already discussed what is resistance. Resistance is a factor which prevent the flow of charges through any conductor. I think it is clear. Now we have three resistance R1, R2, and R3, and we have to connect them in parallel. So in this way, according to this figure, you will connect it R1, R2, R3 and with a battery. When a current I start to flow, it will be distributed to different resistance, and we can say it I1, I2, and I3. Now again, when it will be reached to this point B, they will be already added I1 plus I2 plus I3, and that will be equal to I. So by using this addition, we can find the equivalent resistance of these resistance connected in parallel. So let us see, since I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, equation number 1, and you know that by Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R by Ohm's law. So what will be? I is equal to V by R. So I1 is equal to V by R1. I2 is equal to V by R2. And one thing you have to remember, for every resistance, potential difference will be same in case of parallel connection. So that is why I am taking only V at the place of potential difference. So I is equal to V by I by Ohm's law. That is why I1 is equal to V by R1, I2 is equal to V by R2, and I3 can be written V by R3. Now, by equation 1, I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, then this is V by R, and this is V by R1, V by R2, V by R3. Again, V by R1 and V can be taken in common, 1 by R2, 1 by R3, and finally V will be cancelled out. Then you will get 1 by R is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Now this will be the equivalent resistance. We can write this resistance as equivalent resistance, 1 by R equivalent. And you can take LCM R1, R2 and R3, and finally what will be here, R2 plus R2 R3 plus R1 R3 plus R3, sorry, R1 R2. So when we will do it, we will do it reverse. R equivalent, then it will be also reverse, and R1, R2, R3 divided by R2, R3, R1, R3 plus R1, R2. This is the value of equivalent resistance when resistance, given resistances are connected in parallel. So I hope you understand it. Now I will discuss when we will add these resistance in series, then what will happen. Okay. Now let us see. I am connecting all three resistance in series. Then see what happens. These three resistance are connected in series and a battery is connected to this circuit, and this is R1, R2, R3. There, what is the change? There is a change. Between these point, potential difference will be V1. From this point to this point, potential difference will be V2. And this point, potential difference will be V3. It means, what I want to say, in series connection, for every resistance, potential difference vary, or it is not constant, it changed. And what current is here, current will be same. Here current will be I, here current will be I, and here current will be I. There is no distribution in current, same current will be flow through all the systems, but potential difference will be different. And total potential difference will be equal to this, V. So, we can write V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, at the place of V, we can write I into R, or at the place of V1, I into R1, at the place of V2, I into R2, at the place of V3, I into R3. Finally, you can take common I, and it will be I1, R2 and R3, and it is cancelled out. So R is equal to, here R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. We can say that in case of series connection, equivalent resistance is the algebraic sum of all given resistance. It doesn't matter how many resistance you have, you can take 100 and more than 100 resistance, and you can simply add them. And we have derived this formula. So my dear students, today we have discussed parallel series connection and how to find the formula for equivalent resistance in both cases. In next video, I will teach you how to solve problems based on these formula based on series and parallel connection of resistance. Thank you very much.